on the world's ice stage. All men and women, manly players, they have their physics and their embraces. And one man, in his time, played many parts. His acts been seven ages, at first the infant, mewling and puking in his nurse's arm. And then the whining schoolboy, with his satchel and shining morning face, gripping like snail, unwillingly to school. And then the lover, sighing like furnace, with a woeful ballad made to his mistress eyebrow. Then the soldier, full of strange oaths, and bearded like the part, jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble reputation, even in the cannon's mouth. And then the justice, in fair round belly, with good cap on lined, with eyes severe, and beard of formal cut, full of wise sauce and modern instances, and so he plays his part. The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippery pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and paunch on side, his yellow host will save the world too wide for his shrunk shank and his big manly voice, turning again toward the childish treble, pipes and whistles in his sound. Last scene of all, that ends this strange eventful history. His second childishness and marrow oblivion, sans teeth, sans taste, sans eyes, sans everything.